Hello everybody, how you doing? Welcome back to Clawtour Manufacturing. What we're going to go over on this video is how in the heck do you output the A code with the G code? So what I'm saying is, how do you output from Mastercam so it places your A's in the proper rotations with your work offsets to make one full part? And it's going to be everything you need to make a full program by hitting G1, and it should interpolate everything. Now, before we get going here forward, I do not have Mastercam full version because that's very expensive. And that's why I'm always Patreon this, Patreon that. But I mean, you guys would really be helping me out, you know. And I appreciate the fellow who requested this video. I hope you get something out of this video. And I really appreciate your subscription. Every one of you guys, you know, I really appreciate it. Tell your friends about me. Anyways, let's get moving forward here. So let's dive right in. Okay, so now what you're going to want. Okay, so this is just a part that I made. Very, very basic part. You're going to want your part. So see how it's rotating like this? I mean, that's the plane it's going to be rotating on. It can't be rotating like this or anything like that. Okay, so it's going to be rotating like this. So our trunnion is going to be, our snap head or HRT is going to be over here. Okay, and we're going to have extra stock sticking out back here. All right, so we're going to be able to mill this whole thing. So don't worry about it. All we're doing is we're putting in these two pockets and a couple holes for this example. Now, what you want to do is you want to click your this thing here. Actually, no, you don't. What you want to do is you need to put your part on the dead center of rotation. And how you do that is you hit F9. Okay, and you're going to see where your crosshairs are. Okay, and you're going to need it on the freaking original plane. You know, you're going to start. Don't worry about that. You need your center of rotation on the center line of this axis. Okay, and you're going to be on the top plane when you do this. So you go to your top plane and you want to orientate your part. So this is the center of rotation. So if that point right here, no matter what, when I rotate, this is going to be the center of rotation. I know I keep reiterating that, but it seems like it's kind of not coming through as I'm explaining it that well, because I'm not doing it. So yeah, basically you need to figure out how to put your part on the center of rotation. If you need another video to do that, you got to watch my other videos because I do it a bunch of times. All right. Maybe I do it a bunch of times, and I will in the future if I don't. So sorry, I blew up. So what you're going to want to do, okay, after you get that there, you're going to grab this thing and you're just going to place it there. Boom. Just like that. And you're going to call that plane G54. And you're going to hit green check. Okay. And then you're going to come on here to G54. And make sure all your planes are selected on that. G54 A0. That's what I got it called. And I did my manual at 0. That means it's G54 in your G code when you hit G1 here. All right. So now I'm going to go and I'm going to make my tool path, and I'm going to go contour, and I select these two top lines here, okay? And then I've already done this. So I'm going to come in here to this path, okay? Now that's my G54 path. Very simple. Okay, my G55, I'm just going to come in here, and I'm going to grab that same dot, and I'm just going to rotate this 90 degrees. Bam. Now I'm going to call that G55 A90. All right. Which I already have in there. All right. And then you're going to go into your levels right as soon as you do that before you start programming. Planes. And then you're going to go to your G55, select everything there because that's what you need. If these planes aren't on that, it's going to start programming in other spots and it's going to really piss you off. And then in your manual, you're going to want to put one for G55. Just keep rolling. All right. So then what you want to do is then you're going to want to go in and then select your tool paths. Go in there and go to your pec drill, grab that. Now here's where you got to change it, all right? Go into your planes. So your starting work coordinate system's got to always be G54 A0. That's as simple as that. That's all you need to remember. And the next two planes got to be what the plane you're working on. You got to go in and manually change this, okay? So what you do is you make all your tool paths, okay, for the G55 A90. You right click in there. Oh no, I'll make this for another video. Never mind about any of that malarkey. So just make sure when you come in here for what we're doing, it's going to be best for you to come in here and manually look and see that the very beginning, no matter what, is that. So then let's go to the same thing, G180. Okay, we're going to be based off of this plane. See how we're on G55? We're going to grab this thing right here. We're going to come in here on G55. And now we're going to rotate it 90 degrees again. See how I did that? 90 degrees. Now this is going to be G56. That's going to be A180, I believe. I'm not quite sure. Okay, then you're going to hit green check. And let's go into G56-180 on your levels. Sorry, your planes. Call that manual too. Okay, now you have that. Now we can start making our toolpaths. What you're going to do, what I did is I did a copy and paste that and that. I did a copy and paste. And I went to my parameters and planes. Same thing, G54. Now it's G56-180. See, these are my working coordinates, all based off this coordinate. Now it knows to rotate that. And then finally, we get to G57 here. Let's make another one off of G180. Let's go into our planes, G180. Now we know we need to go 90 degrees from G180. So we'll just keep, we'll grab it. Go 90 degrees. Boom. Okay. G57, A270. Hit green check. Go to that. And now you're going to call that work offset manual number 3. All right. Now you're going to go on your toolpaths, boom, just start toolpathing away. And then when you're done with all your toolpaths, go into each and every one of them till I come out with a video to show you later how to do something else, which for right now you want to come in here and manually do it. It's a good thing to do, okay? Bam. All right. So I hope that helped you out. That should. And if not, leave some things in the description if I left some stuff out. Don't be scared of me, man. I'm going to make videos for you if they're in my caliber. If they're not in my caliber, I will tell you. You know what I'm saying? Don't be afraid, bro. Don't be afraid. And of course, you guys, come on. If I'm helping you out, I need your help. Because, man, it's a struggle where I am right now. And I could use your help, bro. So Patreon me up in the link below if you can. And let's help each other out, man. Let's tell your friends about me and let's get this kicking off. You know, let's get us all whooping some ass. All my Mastercam acts, okay? You guys take it easy, man.